everyone. Welcome to Sunrise. Thank you for joining us. We want to begin with breaking news in Gaza this morning, where the threat of all-out war looms large. Israel is gearing up for its ground assault on Hamas. The barrage of missiles continues to cause major damage.
The humanitarian crisis inside Gaza is becoming ever more desperate by the hour. People are desperate to flee and aid can't get through.
Let's go to our reporters who have all the unfolding developments. First to Europe Bureau Chief Hugh Whitfield. Hugh, it is a desperate situation.
Nat Chervo, good morning. Yeah, look, at one stage today there was hopes of a ceasefire in southern Gaza to allow those Palestinians who may be able to get out through into Egypt via the Rafah crossing to get out and to allow some aid in. The US and Egypt were working on that. Israel and Hamas haven't come to the party, so there has been no truce or temporary ceasefire at all. In fact, at one stage, there are reports that an airstrike targeting the crossing landed, causing an explosion. There are no reports of any injuries, though. The people who would be getting out are mainly those who hold two passports, so Palestinians with a foreign passport, whether that be Australian or American or British or any other country in the world. We know there are 19 Australians inside the Gaza Strip right now. At this stage, there is very limited aid getting in. There are reports that a truck convoy of fuel managed to get through the border, but nothing beyond that. No food, certainly. And Israel says it's turned the water back on in southern Gaza, but whether or not that's actually working is being debated. Israel has continued its bombardment of Gaza today. At this stage, the death toll stands at more than 2,700 Gazans killed. At least 1,000 are missing. Hundreds of children have been killed as part of Israel's bombardment. International aid agencies are using increasingly grim language to describe the situation on the ground there. The UN says hospitals are on the brink of collapse before our eyes. Now, Israel is, it seems, still determined to press ahead with this ground offensive to try and wipe out Hamas on the ground, particularly in northern Gaza. The mobilisation of troops has continued, more than 300,000 soldiers on the ground, and some Australians are going to be fighting in the Israeli Defence Force, including a Melbourne barista I met at Tel Aviv Airport today. He just touched down to be with his family here, preparing to be called up.
I've been called up to the army, so probably in the next few weeks I'll be called in. I want to. I don't want my friends to be there while I'm here as well, so I want to join them and be there as well to support them.
Now, Hamas has continued to fire rockets into Israel today, having said that probably fewer, and the salvos that they fire are probably have less missiles. So are they running out? That will be a question for Israel as it prepares for this ground offensive, as they also try to work out what Hamas will do when Israel invades. Will they fight back? Will they go out in a blaze of glory, or will they melt away into the civilian population, guys?
Thank you, Hugh. Let's go to David Woywood in Washington, D.C. David, U.S. President Joe Biden is reportedly considering a trip to Israel.
Yeah, that's right, Chervo. And of course, a visit by the US president to the region could be viewed a number of ways. Quite clearly, it would be seen as a massive show of support for Israel from the United States. But it's also feared that it could be seen as a provocative move as well by the White House, given the huge numbers of Palestinian victims now caught up in this bloodshed in Gaza. Look, either way, no decision has been made right now. The White House is today saying that nothing is set in stone. Look, behind the scenes here, in Washington, D.C., diplomats are frantically trying to reach out to the Iranian government to try and stop this war from now spiralling into a much broader regional conflict. They have been reaching out via diplomatic channels, intermediaries in the Middle East to get that message to Iran to now back off after its foreign minister posted online today that time is running out for political solutions. Probable spread of war in other fronts is approaching an unavoidable stage. So an incredibly dark and ominous warning there from the Iranians today. Look, the US President Joe Biden, he has been on TV overnight here in the United States. Of course, he is in lockstep with his Israeli counterparts right now, but he did have some advice for them and their long-term military objectives in the Gaza Strip.
it would be a mistake to for Israel to occupy Gaza again. But to going in and taking out the extremists, Hezbollah is up north, but Hamas down south is a necessary requirement.
Yeah, the U.S. president there. Look, here in the United States, intelligence officials right across the country right now, they are really on high alert for fear of reprisal attacks, especially after a six-year-old boy in Chicago was actually murdered by a neighbour, and police have confirmed that he was targeted, guys, incredibly sadly, because he was Palestinian.
OK, thank you both. We'll have more right through the morning. Welcome back to Sunrise. Thank you for joining us. In breaking news at 6:30, the World Health Organization is warning Gaza is at crisis point, with the lives of tens of thousands of people at immediate risk, with aid trucks prevented from entering the strip from Egypt. The Palestinian territory is almost out of food, water and medicines.
More than half the population has fled their homes, gathering at the Rafah border in Gaza's south, hoping to flee the looming ground invasion. Let's go live to US Bureau Chief David Woywood for the latest. Dave, as the humanitarian crisis grows, President Biden is considering travelling to Israel.
He is. Good morning, guys. Look, a presidential visit to the region. It is on the cards at the moment, although it could be interpreted a number of ways. Quite clearly, many people would see this as a major vote of support for Israel from the United States, if indeed it was to happen. But now it's also being feared that this could be seen as a provocative move from the US President Joe Biden, given the huge number of civilian casualties now caught up in that bloodshed inside Gaza. Look, nothing is set in concrete right now. The White House is still mulling that over. Here in Washington, though, diplomats have been working around the clock. They have been trying to get messages to Iran and the Iranian officials right now to try and stop this war from actually spiraling into a much larger regional conflict. They have been back-channeling through a number of other countries inside the Middle East after the Iranian foreign minister posted this online. Time is running out for political solutions. Probable spread of war in other fronts is approaching and unavoidable at this stage. So an incredibly dark and ominous message there from the Iranian government. Look, there is no doubt the United States at the moment is in lockstep with Israel, but the US President Joe Biden, look, he went on TV last night and he had a message for his Israeli partners in this. He has questioned them and their motives for their long-term plans for the Gaza Strip.
It would be a mistake to for Israel to occupy Gaza again. But to going in and taking out the extremists, Hezbollah is up north, but Hamas down south is a necessary requirement.
And right here in the United States now, look, intelligence officials around the country, they are on high alert for fear of reprisal attacks domestically.
Yeah, thank you very much, David. And the trouble is the world's been on high alert for days now. They drafted those 300,000, remember, days ago, and everyone's been sitting there for several days waiting to see whether, you know, they're
really
going to go in.
Really interesting to hear those comments from Joe Biden, clearly. And Antony Blinken had been to those neighbouring countries and spoken to leaders there. Clearly there has been discussions. Joe Biden potentially will go to Israel as well. But the biggest part of this is the US back Israel. They don't want to have a Middle Eastern war right now. So they know Israel has a job to do with Hamas and they're backing that, but they don't want this to escalate so much that they're then fighting with Lebanon, Hezbollah potentially, Iran as well.
Tuesday morning on Sunrise, in breaking news at 7:30, a warning from aid agencies that Gaza is on the brink of a humanitarian catastrophe. The lives of tens of thousands of people are at immediate risk, with aid trucks prevented from entering the strip from Egypt. The Palestinian territory is almost out of food, water and medicines.
More than half the population has fled their homes, gathering at the Rafah border in Gaza's south, hoping to flee the looming ground invasion. Let's go live to CNN correspondent Rafael Romo in Tel Aviv. Rafael, for those in Gaza, it must feel like a hopeless situation right now.
Yeah, that is correct, Matt and Natalie. And the reality is that they're trapped. They have nowhere to go. Obviously, they cannot cross any of the borders into Israel. The only border that they would be able to cross is the one connecting to Egypt. That's the Rafah border crossing, but it has been shut for the last week now since all the hostilities started. And they're in a very desperate situation, with the World Health Organization saying that Gaza is going to run out of water anytime now, they say. And we have continued to hear explosions in the air here in Tel Aviv, and a CNN team also saw multiple rockets coming out of Gaza into Sderot in the last few hours. Incoming missiles have been so frequent that, imagine this, even U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, and the country's war cabinet had to shelter in a bunker for 5 minutes when air raid sirens went off here in Tel Aviv. Secretary of State Antony Blinken is back in this city for a second time in as many weeks. Earlier, he met with Israeli Defense Minister Yoav Gallant and expressed the United States' deep commitment to Israel's right to defend itself, adding that Israel will always have the support of the United States. Now back to you, Natalie and Matt.
Back now for our 8 a.m. hour. Let's get straight to unfolding developments in Gaza this morning, where frightened civilians are bracing for all-out war. Israel's ground assault on Hamas could happen at any moment as the aerial bombardment continues to cause major damage.
Aid agencies are demanding convoys of humanitarian aid be let into the Palestinian territory, while thousands wait in vain for the border with Egypt to open.
Let's go to our reporters who have all the latest from the ground. Let's go first to Europe Bureau Chief Hugh Whitfield. Gaza's on the brink of catastrophe.
Yeah, Nat, good morning. Shervo, the aid agencies from all over the world talking in increasingly grim and dark language about the situation on the ground in Gaza. The UN says that the hospital system there is collapsing before our eyes. Others talk about Gaza being strangled. There was hope at one stage today of a ceasefire that might have allowed the border crossing into Egypt to open, the Rafah crossing. That ceasefire broke down, it didn't go anywhere, so the border crossing has remained closed. It means that many dual nationals, foreigners, including Australians, haven't been able to get out. It's also made the delivery of aid into Gaza very difficult. We know that that Israeli siege has taken hold over the last week or so. No food, no fuel getting in. Israel says it's turned the water back on. We're yet to see what impact that may have. But it is increasingly appearing as though a humanitarian catastrophe is unfolding in real time. Israel is continuing its bombing campaign of Gaza. Of course, it is preparing for a ground assault, widely anticipated ground assault. It says to wipe out Hamas. It also wants to get its hostages back. The Israeli government now says 199 people are being held hostage by Hamas, and there are big efforts, obviously, to get them back. But there is no ground invasion just yet. The big decision will come from the Prime Minister, Benjamin Netanyahu.
Thank you, Hugh. Let's go to David Woywood in Washington, D.C. Dave, breaking news this hour. U.S. President Joe Biden is weighing up a trip to Israel.
He is, and look, it would be a bold move if he went through with it. Look, clearly many people would love to see a presidential visit to the region right now. It would be viewed as a major vote of support for Israel from the United States. But it's also feared that it could be interpreted as a provocative move and potentially tone-deaf as well from the US president. So the White House is now just mulling this over. Certainly nothing is set in stone right now. Here in Washington, D.C., look, officials have been working around the clock to try and prevent this conflict from now spiraling into a much wider regional war. And we know that US officials have been speaking to middlemen in the Middle East. They're trying to get that message to Iranian officials to back off after the Iranian foreign minister posted this online today. Time is running out for political solutions. Probable spread of war in other fronts is approaching an unavoidable stage. An incredibly dark warning there, guys, from these Iranian officials.
Okay, thank you both.